lovelies. Welcome back again to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time here, you are welcome. Please do subscribe to the channel. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for always coming back. So today I have Bolu again on the channel. All right, Bolu, just tell them your name for those that were not here the last time.
Okay, my name is Bolu.
Tell them that your name is Bolu. Tell them your full name now. Do you know that somebody's crushing on you? Please, her name is Bolu. Welcome to another episode of Unpopular Opinion. And today we'll be reacting to a very interesting story. Let me just read the story to you guys. We don't want this video to be too long. We have been together 2 years and 10 months now. We are engaged and have done introduction. I'm 7 months pregnant and it's not been easy. I was already 2 months gone before I realized I was pregnant. I became really sick and on bed rest for weeks. When I was discharged, I had to stop working. I'm a caterer and a makeup artist. I started staying home, actually in my fiance's place, since we've done introduction. Before any little argument, the next thing he will say is leave my house. Not once or twice, but countless times. I will cry and cry. Sometimes I will stay with stubbornness and we will make up. He said it again, and with anger, I left to my parents' house. He stopped picking my calls, and he doesn't call me. I've been really sick. I needed to see my doctor. I called and called. He refused to pick. When he finally picked, I asked him why he was not picking up. He said because my calls are always about money. Right now, I don't know what I feel for him, whether anger or hatred. I just don't know, and this feeling wants to make me wish him bad. I just want him to taste all this he's doing to me, if they are good. I'm in so much regret right now. Sister Equitos, what do you have to say about this?
Okay. From full this life story, in this video. From this story that me have heard though. Okay. She realized that she was pregnant 2 months after the introduction. And she had to stop her work. Okay. She is the guy that said she should stop, ba? The guy said she should stop.
No, the guy did not say she should stop. She said she had to stop because of her pregnancy.
Okay,
She fell sick now. She felt sick. She now stopped working.
Mm-hmm. And the guy already said it now, that anytime that she calls, there is always money related issue. She's now a liability now.
He's
already seen her like a liability. Because if not, there's nothing that will stop somebody that you're pregnant for, that you guys have even gotten engaged, safe. There's nothing that will stop him from taking your calls. He knows that you're pregnant with his baby now. He will be worried anytime that any call he gets from you is a distress call. He'll be worried about that. Maybe something is wrong or there's an emergency or something. But the thing that made him say it, that opened his mouth and made him tell you that
your call is always about money.
All is always money related issue that used to call him about. Then you have entered one chance now. So you have packed your load and go. He has said that. It's always money.
Me, I don't understand. Like me personally, I don't believe in moving into a guy's house before like marriage. Like before introduction is not marriage now. She said introduction.
That's where she got it wrong now. They have not gotten married. Just ordinary introduction. You have carry your bobo to go and enter his house. No wala now.
See, even married people, they broke.
My people are even breaking up. Not to not talk of you that you just got engaged. Introduction. Just introduce you. That they just introduce you.
Okay, I was putting it as, okay, you know that in Igbo tradition, sometimes during introduction, they'll pay bride price. We'll just call it introduction, but then it's email go. Oh, but this time it's just introduction.
Just introduction.
Okay, just Bolu, come and meet my family. My parents.
Meet my fiance.
Okay, she now
she just pack a load.
Until you said you not try. And not you say you even moving. You moving and started eating the forbidden fruit in the garden of Eden. In the garden of Eden.
She moved in and started enjoying wifey benefit. Now the wifey benefit have tired you now. Now it's not see you as a liar. You don't tire him. You know, you don't wake up. You call your life say, not be the life right sign up
but
for
some
me,
guys,
so.
Sha.
I beg.
Some guys are wicked, sha. But this thing is wickedness.
Haba. I don't understand.
This wickedness.
How is it wickedness? From my own point of view,
this witchcraft. This witchcraft. Don't say that.
How is it witchcraft? You backed and entered my house. I did not send you a message.
She's pregnant for him now.
Because you are pregnant does not mean that you have to pack him. The thing that make you to pack him will make you to enjoy the consequences.
Please, enjoy people, it. Drop your opinion enjoy in the comment section.
Enjoy it. Because from my point of view, the mistake, I realize that the mistake most ladies are making right now is that they are not seeing guys as a source of income. Because you got pregnant, okay, fine, you got pregnant for him, but you guys are not even married. It does not warrant that you move all your things into his house.
Or even quit
because
your job.
Because
he didn't ask her to quit her job.
He didn't ask you. Okay, yes, you are pregnant. There are a lot of pregnant women that are still working. So,
and you know the funny thing?
There's a difference between being
I feel like the job that she's doing, she can even do it from her house. Makeup artist and catering.
Imagine.
And she quit.
It's not something that if you have to be in a particular place to be doing. It's not something you have to. You can be working and be earning your money while you're pregnant now. But as you have.
But not everybody have that energy, shall
we? Now we just want to relax and be taken care of.
So now, in conclusion, what is your opinion on this matter? Like, what do you think? They ask you to advise this couple. What are you going to advise them?
My own sincere advice for her is that thing. See, let her get her life straight.
Ah, bully,
this blocks. Guy is not me. I'm just being honest though.
Vina, your senior
okay,
sister.
From looking at this right now and from this story entirely, this guy is actually not meant for her. Because what if they actually get married?
They've not gotten married though. Just 7 months into the
relationship. Imagine they've not actually gotten married and all of this is happening already. What if they now get married? A lot of things are happening even with married couples. Not to now talk of someone that you have not even gotten married to.
Yes.
So the best thing is that pregnancy is not a mistake. It has happened. You guys can do co-parenting. It can be, you know, you guys can be splitting the bills of the child. Find your square root, sister. from the bottom of my heart, I'm just saying the truth. Just find your square root. Look for a man that suits you because this one is not for you.
What if it's a temporary misunderstanding?
You
don't know.
From where to where?
Okay.
Somebody that is pregnant with your child, though. You know that.
Your opinion is not about me.
She's the one that is telling you this.
It's your opinion you're asking for.
That's it. Because if you are pregnant somebody's child and he does not even care about you, no. So what's not the essence of the introduction that you could have done?
Seriously, because obviously pregnant, it means that he doesn't even care about
He does not care about you, talk less of caring about the child that you are even carrying in your stomach. At the end of the day, this one, now once you get pregnant to the child, you hear that I cannot marry you again. Because that time that you've packed into his house, you have been doing all the wifey duties for him. He's tired of seeing your face. He does not need you any longer.
Once so, young lady, in essence, introduction
does not mean marriage at all.
Bride price payment safe.
Don't be marriage. I'm not married, and they come up pay bride price.
But they're always close to that. How many steps remain to marriage? Just like
have
see gutter, yeah. Imagine just gutter. Cross and go the other side. Now
with all this that happened now, there's no opportunity to even cross the gutter again.
If you are watching it, don't worry, you have hope. Yeah. Just be praying, you know, these things happen.
Oh.
Like coming from inside, or you even get a marriage relationship coach.
Ah, what a touching story.
Ah, but then I did my first episode of Popular Opinion. It's when a relationship coach snatched her client's boyfriend. I will link that video down below for you to go and watch it in case you have not watched it.
Then we still snatch this one too away. Anyways, on this one, it's just that we girls just need to calm down and this marriage thing, they know they take let's come out for marriage.
They know they call register for marriage.
There are people that are actually 37 years. I've seen a lady that is 37 years and she just got married and she got married to
a well-to-do man that got married at 50.
I don't know. Did they
catch and she said that she's having an amazing.
But at the end of the day, Shia, you realize that it's all these Nigerian settings that are just making girls just rush into marriage.
You know, women have biological clock and it's ticking.
And women, you already have what you want to do. By 24, I want to be married. By 27, I want to have 3 kids.
All of us had that dream.
Yes, I want to have 3 kids, you know, with Benz. Everything has to be set. I have to be, you know,
financially.
When I come out, yes, I have to be financially okay. You know. That's what is making all of us to just rush into what we are not even ready for.
Nah,
in marriage, self, you go enter so and go tire you. That's it now. The pressure coming from the society, coming from parents. Parents are one of the contributing factors of rushing into.
It's just like if you was not plenty for getting married.
I'm like, what's wrong with us right now? You just see everybody wearing a shwebi.
Nah,
you just want them to wear a shwebi for you.
Guys, thank you so much for watching up until this point. This brings us to the end of this video. If you did enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up, share with your family and friends, subscribe if you've not. And I'm going to drop Bolu's Instagram handle in the description as usual. Go and hit her up. Let you people continue your whatever it is from there, okay? And on this note, we'll see you in another video. Bye!